Nakikita ko po sa mga taga-urban na yung pagiging kumpleto nila.
Dito sa paaralan to, mas pinapahalagahan nila yung values ng isang bata.
Ini-inspired po nila kami, tapos sina-challenge para matuto po kami maigi.
Napakalaking tulong po, lalo po sa amin na parang, ano po, yung hindi na po siguro kayang mag-provide ng studies para sa college. Parang ready na po kami para mag-work in the future.
Our population is increasing, now close to 90 million, because a big number were poor. I think the best way to prepare them to educate first. But without education, there's no way to get out of poverty.
As a social worker, I joined IRDA because I like the mission of Father Treats, which is helping children go back to school and have access to quality education.
How do you start doing that? When you look at the child, there's so many things that this child would need. So just by that alone, you would say, can I really do something?
Now he has a poor child who has no chance to get educated in any way. So put yourself in a condition. What would you like people to do for you? So do it for them. I met Mother Teresa in India. I met her, and she's quite inspired me to work with the poor. That's why I started with this area, to get the poor a chance to get educated. Once educated, find a job, get out of poverty. Giving money will not solve the problem. But educating them and prepare them for work, yes.
Education is a basic right of every child. So we must really address this right. It's not the privilege of only for those who have money.
Nagme-meeting kami para explain sa mga magulang na ang mission ng IRDA ay wala kang pinipili. Kasi basta bata ka na nangangailangan ka ng tulong sa school assistance, pwede kang tulungan ng IRDA.
Researchers would always point out that a person who has had the privilege of being educated earn more than those people who have not been educated at all.
So we started the foundation, and we started with a few children, and this year about 33,000. But that is still a small number compared to children who are out of school.
When we work with our youth groups, when we see them band together and start planning, so that's to me the most exciting, because you see them with a lot of hope that there is something they can do now and the future can be better for them.
Itong school na to hindi ordinary kasi meron siyang technical subjects.
Every first Friday of the month po, meron po kaming misa. Kaya po, nabago po ako nito simula nung pumasok po ako.
Sa IRDA Tech po, yung emosyon, yung moral, yung spiritual, pati po yung utak. Nahahasa po talaga.
Sa technical subjects na to, dun ako makakakuha ng mga bagay na pwedeng makatulong sa akin sa future.
Parang nire-ready po kami para sa work pagkatapos po namin mag-high school or mag-college.
EDA Tech is a combination of EDA if you want to. EDA is an educated child. And EDA Tech is not only to educate him, but to prepare him for work. So this school in Bandakan takes care of children who are very poor children, give them a chance for basic secondary education. In addition to that, 2 hours a day, spend 2 hours a day to learn a skill. We have about 700 children. We could have many more because the building is for 2,000. So at 50, they learn really a skill, they learn it well. They don't find a job immediately. They are poverty. That's the solution. Give money will solve the problem. But prepare them to work, yes. That's the solution.
We organize children. We empower children to be active in local governance,
yung hindi lang sila mere recipients of services, yung mga support assistance ng IRDA, but they are into participating in local governance, like participating in the barangay.
Well, the good challenge for me, because of my work, is to find the money. Napoleon said, money is the nerve of the war. My wife didn't kill him, my wife is to save people.
Some of the programs, very limited ang funding, so sana naman kami kukuha ng funding for the next coming year.
We don't have all the resources that we would want to, so we can reach out to more. Because we're discussing millions out there.
Marami kasi sa mga ginagawa namin. Kasi every year na nagpa-plano kami, talaga namang hindi kompleto ang budget namin, no? Tapos sasabihin niya lang sa amin, don't worry, God will provide. Alam mo, totoo talaga. Kasi bago matapos ang school year, nakukompleto naman yung funding namin. Yun, so, yun na nga yung sometimes na hindi mo talaga matatawaran kay Father. Yung ano niya, yung faith, napakalakas.
I say I can be of use to help the people. Many people to helping a child to go to school. For the child is the best thing for him. I said, this is more important for me to help the children to be properly educated and go to school and have a decent life later on.
They have dreams. Like anyone else, these children have dreams. And they'd like to see their dreams come true.
Para po kay Father Tits, gusto ko po magpasalamat. Kasi kung hindi dahil sa kanya at hindi niya tinayo itong school na madamang ano, maraming mga estudyante ang hindi nakapag-aral.
Si Father Fritz po yung isa po sa mga tao na ginawa ko pong inspirasyon. Kasi po, kundi po dahil sa kanya, wala po ako dito eh.
Kung magkakaroon naman ako ng magandang future, gagawin ko po yung mga ginagawa niya. Tutulong ako sa iba. Sa mga estudyante, masaya na po sa mga estudyante katulad ko na gusto makapag-aral, kaso hindi dahil sa kahirapan.
Gusto ko pong ipakita sa kanya na kapag natapos po ako, nakatapos po ako dito sa IRDA, hindi po masasayang yung privilege, yung pribileyo na binigay niya po sa akin para po makapag-aral sa foundation na tinayo niya.
I have no idea I'm at age. I think we are made to work, very kind like that. Can be of help to some poor people while you retire. So it doesn't make sense to me to retire. So I want to use my life as long as possible.